Hey guys, Lucas here and welcome at Case New Space. Wow, wow, wow. Have you seen Peter Beck's presentation on Neutron? If not, watch it, it's crazy. The link's below. There were some rumors in the beginning about Neutron being some kind of an Antares variant of some sorts. It launches off the same pad, has the same number of payload mass, and even has the same dimensions. However, I think it turned out different from what anyone has imagined. Those early renditions were completely off. I'm not sure if this was just some kind of a disguise or if they changed their plans. So let me get right into the most important innovation here. I think this might change everything. A rocket normally consists of multiple stages that are stacked on top of each other. Each stage holds their own weight and the weight of whatever is above that. What that leads to is that the upper stage has to withstand forces during launch like atmospheric pressure, shearing, and whatnot. However, it does not need to withstand all that once separated. An upper stage is therefore by nature over-engineered for its job. And that adds mass and reduces its performance. That's a big deal because an upper stage goes all the way to orbit where the payload goes. Not so on Neutron. Instead of stacking the upper stage on top of the booster reaches all the way to the payload attachment ring. The payload is held by the booster, not the upper stage. The upper stage is pretty much just dangling off of the same mount. And as if that wasn't enough, the payload fairings stay attached to the booster as well. Crazy. What Rocket Lab is building is the world's first 1.21 stage booster. Great, Scott. It's more than just one stage as it partially takes the job of the upper stage. That's important to understand. It goes a step further than SpaceX Falcon 9. I think they are really onto something when it comes to rapid reuse. Sure, SpaceX Starship will be fully reusable whereas Rocket Lab still expands the upper stage, but it's just half a stage. And I think it's even more than just a step between Falcon 9 and Starship. It's a step in a slightly different direction. Starship still faces the same problems than any other rocket. It's a stage stacked on top another, so it has to be over-engineered. Now that big over-engineered ship has to be able to return back to ground. It all adds mass. The approach of a dangling upper stage could lead to an entirely different, fully reusable vehicle in the future. So Rocket Lab's future has just changed from following in SpaceX's footsteps to making its own footmarks. I really believe this is great news for Rocket Lab. It has become much more unpredictable and therefore interesting. But what do you think about it? Let me know in the comments. Auf Wiedersehen and thank you for watching.